Garry's Mod in VR? Yes, this is possible now because there is a VR mod that can change Garry's Mod to a VR mode. This is really cool. So we can spawn stuff. We have room scale, we have Vive controller support, and I already played it with the Pimax. So my name is Voodoo and you can find hardware tests, news, games and events on my channel. Let's have some fun with Garry's Mod VR and let's go!
Voodoo.de.
Okay guys, here we are in Garry's Mod VR. And yeah, you know this map perhaps. This is one of the standard maps. And we have a tool here. This is the teleport tool, so we can aim and teleport around. This is the only locomotion for now. Then we can push the grip button and then we have the gravity gun. I will show you how this works. And then the next thing is we have our bare hands. So let's go to the teleport tool. There's a problem with this menu, so I have to go to the edge of my room space and then we have the menu here. Do you see that? Oh yes, I think you see that. So, for example, we can spawn some stuff here, like this one, or sofa here, and a barrel, and then we can click touchpad again, and now we can move that with the gravity gun. Shoo. Oh yeah. It doesn't explode. Also, we can do this with other stuff as well. but this is not the only thing you can do. So you can, of course, give me a second. Also spawn some weapons here, like the AR2 gun. Look at this. Click, 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 click. Isn't that nice? So now we have the weapon, and let's spawn some NPCs here, like first some friends. Alex, where is she? Hi, Alex, and of course Mr. G-Man. Hello, Mr. G-Man, and Doc. Wow. Nice. And now let's spawn a... No, wait. Let's go a little bit back here. Cool, isn't it? And now let's spawn a weapon first. This one. And now let's spawn some enemies. Like the Combined Soldier. This one. Nice. Dog is running there. Where is that guy? Yeah. He's dead. He is dead. That was pretty easy, but let's spawn a bigger one. Or now this is bad, so you cannot choose it while you have a weapon in your hand, and if you change it to another tool, then you lose your weapon again. So this sucks a little bit, of course. So what we have to have a weapon in our hand, otherwise we don't have any chance here. NPCs. So what do we have here? What about the Antlion Guard? Oh sh! No, no, no! No, wait! No, he's killing G-Man! Wait. Wait. Let's get a better weapon here. Grenade launcher. Where's the red dot? There's the red dot. Hi, my friend. That's it. That's it. It's empty. Oh no, it's empty. Damn. So, I want to have this one again. Let's try to kill dog with it. Does it work? Where's the red dot? Huh? Damn, we only have it once. Click, 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 click. Ah. Hello, hello, dog. Do you see it? That looks really cool here. Wow. Hi, Alex. I love the G-Man is always standing here and. Oh, I'm sorry for making your nice clothes dirty. Okay, so this is what you can do here, guys. You can also spawn a vehicle. Oh, wait, but we cannot use that. That's a problem. It doesn't work. I at least I don't know how it should work. Hovercraft. What you can do it works, but of course it's a little bit buggy. It doesn't work like I expected. It's pre alpha, I would say. So the weapons are disappearing. The menu is nearly impossible to handle because you have to walk a few meters to reach it if you activate it. It's very strange here, but however, I can tell you how you set it up, guys. Okay, guys, that was Gary's Mod VR, and yeah, I think I cannot really recommend it for now. It's okay, it's fun, it's cool, but there are so many bugs and so many things that you wouldn't expect that happen. And yeah, however, I will tell you how this works. So this is the mod from the SteamVR workshop. The link you can find here is very important. I put it under this video and then you can check it out. So what you're gonna do is go to this website, then you need to be logged in Steam, and you have to install your Gary's mod. You have to install Gary's mod in SteamVR, and then you click on subscribe here. This is my German page, but with you, you will find subscribe button here. And then he's already downloading this mod in the background when you click this button. And then it's installed. However, if you do not already have Gary's mod, do not buy it to play this. It's not worth it, guys. I can really tell you it's not worth it. However, if you already have Gary's mod, then you should give it a try because the VR mod is for free. So what you're gonna do is you also have to download a file, a zip file. This is linked here. It's on Google Drive for now. I think you will change this later. So download this file, unpack it, and then you will have some files there. Open your Steam directory and go to Steam VR Apps Common and then Gary's Mod, and also open this file here, and then you have to copy some files to some folders, and this is described in the installation txt that you will find also in this zipped file here. This is very important, otherwise it will not really work. So he already told us it's unfinished, very hacky, performance is bad, projection is not perfect. Yeah, I will tell you how that works later, but I cannot tell that the performance is very bad. So I played it with the Pimax 8K, and it works very good. It was not a problem. However, I got a 2080 Ti, so this is a very good graphics card. So I put the Pimax on my head, and then it worked without a problem. So what you gonna do? Start SteamVR first. Start SteamVR,
Then check if everything works, if the controllers are connected, and if you see the SteamVR home environment. Then go to Garry's Mod and start Garry's Mod. He will tell you that the game is not supported by VR. Ignore it and just say yes, start it anyway. Then do not go under your headset. Go to your PC, go to your keyboard and mouse, and go load a level. Load any level you want to play in Garry's Mod. And then you hold the Q button. When the level is loaded, hold the Q button, then go to Utilities. This is in the upper right corner. And then go to Virtual Reality and VR Mod. This is where there is a button that says Start in SteamVR Mode. If you click this button, then you will switch to the two window modes so that you have the 3D vision. And however, you should first check this little thing. It says show display offset calibration. This is what you should do for the first time, and then you can choose the right offset, the IPD. I will call it IPD with the A and D button of your keyboards. Hold the buttons and then look how it works the best for you, how it looks best, and then you can deactivate this offset calibration tool, and then you can play it. You only need one controller, and you have the with the trigger you can fire, and with the grip button you can switch the weapons, and with the touchpad you can go to the menus. So that's how it works, guys. If you want to give it a try, then hit the subscribe button, and if not, don't buy the game to play this. It's not worth it, really, guys. However, if you like the video, guys, then give me thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and see you next time in virtual reality. See ya!